Hi friends, today we will see about anticholinergic syndrome. Before that, what is cholinergic? This is a term used to refer to the molecule acetylcholine. Acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter within the central and peripheral nervous system. This is the chief neurotransmitter in the parasympathetic nervous system, the part of autonomic nervous system that contracts smooth muscles, dilate blood vessels, increase body secretions and slow down the heart. Now, what is anticholinergic agents? A substance that blocks the neurotransmitter acetylcholine in central and peripheral nervous system. It will inhibit the parasympathetic nerve impulses by selectively blocking the binding of acetylcholine from its receptors. Now, we will come back to our topic. What is anticholinergic syndrome? It is produced by the inhibition of cholinergic neurotransmission at the muscarinic receptor site. It may follow the wide range of prescription and over-the-counter medication. It may be caused by intentional overdose and medical non-compliances, poisonous plants and mushrooms. Cases have been noted after general anesthesia, and the systemic effect also have resulted from topical eye drops. Next, you will see the signs and symptoms. The patient may be present with the flushing, dry skin and mucous membrane, mydriasis, the pupil dilation, and altered mental status and fever. And some additional manifestations are include like sinus tachycardia, hypertension, and decreased bowel sounds and urinary retention. Then the diagnosis. Actually, there is no definite diagnostic studies exist for this anticholinergic syndrome or anticholinergic overdose. We need to do a proper history and physical examination, and the lab studies may be helpful, like serum electrolytes and chemistry, blood and urine culture for the fever patient, and ABGs. And imaging studies like CT, MRI, and ECGs, and procedures like lumbar puncture. For the management, mainly supportive and symptomatic. The patient with the recent less than 1 hour clinically significant ingestion can be given a single dose of activated charcoal to prevent or to reduce the gastric absorption. An inpatient with a depressed conscious level should be intubated and secure the airway. The antidote for the anticholinergic toxicity is physostigmine salicylate, and it is contraindicated in patients with cardiac conduction disturbances. Most of the anticholinergics have large volume of distribution and are highly protein bound, so the hemodialysis and hemoperfusion are ineffective. Patients often recover with supportive. Tachycardia may be responsive to crystalloid infusion, and control of hyperthermia with antibiotics and active cooling measures, control of agitation with benzodiazepine, manage seizure with lorazepam or diazepam, and ventricular tachyarrhythmias can be treated with lidocaine, and catheterize the urinary retention patient, and admit the patient in ICU settings until a symptoms-free period of 4 to 6 hours without any supports or antidotes. Hope you enjoy my class. Thanks for watching.